first opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Carolina Panthers and the Chicago Bears. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
For the first time with David Montgomery. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It'll go as a loss of three right away, and it's second down.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. They'll run for the first time with Tariq Cohen. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14.
Makes it third and 14.
So certainly not the start they were looking for here as they come up on a third and 14. They're going to look to throw. And he's got Lockett. And all the way down to the 37. A big play there for the Bears on third. 46 yards.
And 10 at the 37-yard line.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now Montgomery, and this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Behind the chain, second and 12. He'll look to throw. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry. Touchdown, Chicago! Jarvis Landry, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bears have taken the early lead. That touchdown, certainly a welcome sight. Remember, they were shut out last week. They talked to us about getting early momentum. Well, here you go in the opening quarter.
Got to rebuild confidence, because when you get shut out, I don't care how strong you are mentally, you've got to take a step back and say, okay, what just happened here? Because nothing that we were doing worked well enough to get into the end zone. And that's a nice confidence-building drive, one that puts it in the end zone to give them an opportunity.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Christian McCaffrey. And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of four.
The ball carrier.
And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
Back to throw. Brennan. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And brought down down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Now a throw for the left sideline, and he's got it.
Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Call that a very strong gain of 24.
First down, Carolina.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Taken down.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. This is McCaffrey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards there and a first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. That catch good for only a couple. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs. Hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
Third down.
As he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
On for the field goal. A 31-yard attempt.
And his kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Brings up second and 5 at the 28-yard line.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. Let's go, D, time it up. They'll look to throw here. And that's going to be incomplete.
The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fielded just inside the 20. We'll call that a 49-yard punt, but a net of just 39 following the 10-yard return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in. But I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today. So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Off the play fake, Brennan. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked up by Jaren Johnson. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 49-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. But what do you think? You get the ball off the turnover near the middle of the field. You take a shot here on the first play?
You know I'm big on that. I love when I have great field position after a turnover. I feel like I might have them a little bit off balance. I prefer to take a shot, but a lot of coaches will tell you you only do it if you trust the guy who's got the football in his hands. Meaning, if it's not there, he won't force it downfield and maybe turn into an interception. He'll go to the check down, go to a second option, and go ahead and take the play that's in front of him.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 26-yard line. Now a shotgun handoff to Cohen. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Second and 11. Gets this to his running back, Tariq Cohen. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now back to throw. The screen pass here to Cohen. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the six. It'll go as a loss on the play, not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal.
At the Panthers' six-yard line.
Second and goal from the six this time. Toss to the left with Cohen. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up.
We all know how much running backs love getting the ball down near the goal line. They think they're going to find a way into the end zone. He hasn't had that kind of luck so far. Ends up not getting in.
And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Jarvis Landry. with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Bears will add on to their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Yeah, after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
8 yards on the pickup brings up second and two.
McCaffrey, and he'll get this only up to about the 35. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one. The good run on first down followed up by a not so good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Try and pick it up with McCaffrey. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Brought down right at.
Yes, it's the first half, but we'll see if that stuff there on third and one comes back to haunt him.
I hope you don't mind, but it's not going to stop me from putting a check mark next to this play. Let's look back as this game progresses and see if this is one of the key plays in the game, even though it occurred early.
So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. Back deep, the dangerous Tyler Lockett. This is taken at the 15. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And the Bears take over.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So from the 36 now, first and 10. He'll look to throw. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Nick Bosa, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. On play action, they'll throw. They'll lock it with a grab over the middle. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
48-yard line.
McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Looking to throw. Brennan firing quickly here, and that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
Carolina.
Back to throw. Brennan. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. With McCaffrey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half.
First down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Complete out to Samuel on the quick throw. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
The 10-yard line. It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and 1 yard.
Ball resting on the 10-yard line. It's 2nd and 1. Operating from the gun. Brennan, this will be caught at about the 6. And the Panthers are going to be set up with a 1st and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. Now the Panthers going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Gun. Brennan, this is caught, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey in the final seconds of the first half, and the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. Until that late score here in the second quarter, they only had the field goal, so that's just big to see that football get into the end zone.
Yeah, when you look at the scoreboard now, nothing seems out of reach. They've been outplayed in the first half. But when the clock hits zeros as they head into the half, you know what I do as a head coach?
What?
I tell my team to sprint to the locker room to show that we've got the momentum and show that we're right back in this game.
At their own 25-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Second and six, just inside the 30. They'll throw now on the final play. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out there and ready to begin their next drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. His throw incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, and it'll bring up third down.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone. That they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
On third down, Brennan completes it to Samuel. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. Here's a quick throw out left. That's caught. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Operating from the gun. Brennan to the right side, and he's got Moore complete. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. Back to throw again.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And they run the option on second down. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
To throw on third down, Brennan, that's caught by Hollister. And he'll be stopped short of the first down as they rally to tackle him at about the 28. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And this one is right down Broadway. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
So the hold on special teams backs him up all the way inside the 15 to start. Now a handoff looking right. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
At the 14-yard line.
A third quarter now, to 1-point game as they line up second and 10. They'll look to throw into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25, and they'll have the ball set up in the red zone at the 16-yard line.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head, drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They'll try to get the running game going with McCaffrey. He will push his way down to about the 14. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
The last run got a couple here, second and 8. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And he'll get about 3 just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5. On 3rd down, they're going to go with the option. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. The 5-yard gain, and now they're set up 1st and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
They all understand that even after that loss on first down, they've got a field goal attempt in their back pocket. But here on second and goal, this is the time you take your shot at the end zone, I believe. Go ahead and go for the big shot right now, knowing you can always come back and kick a field goal on fourth down if you can't advance.
Now from the 9, here's second and goal. On second and goal, here's the option. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal. Try to power it in with Arma. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And this is picked up by the Bears. He's at the 50. The 30. The 20. 10. And they bring this one back. A fumble return for a Bears touchdown. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
And he knocks it through.
Makes the score Bears 21, Panthers 13. Jason Myers.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they'll be looking to start fresh. Just a moment ago, they were backed up, coughed up the football, and then saw it go the other way for 6 points.
I just wonder, partner, sometimes they put such an emphasis on things. And you know, in that situation, as they ran out there, they were told, take care of the football, don't cough it up. And sometimes that's the last thing you hear, and that's exactly what you did.
13.
2nd and 6, just inside the 30. Here's McCaffrey. Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Off play action, Brennan. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 27 yards there, a first down.
And the Panther first down.
From the gun, Brennan. Short pass to the tight end, Hollister. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10.
At the 46-yard line.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive. And here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
On 1st and 10, Brennan. And that is incomplete. Jacob Hollister, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up, 2nd and 10. Throwing again, Brennan. Flushed out right. He rifles complete, caught by Moore. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. They get 6, that'll leave them with 3rd and 4. The Panthers on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is 3rd and 4.
operating from the gun. Brennan. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And his kick is good. And that'll get the lead down to five. So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. Now let's check on the call. Play fake. Brennan. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. The end result, 21 yards.
First down, Panthers.
From the gun, Brennan. Quick hitter here, it's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
Brings up second.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Oh, no, he lost the football. Could have been a costly mistake, but as it turns out, they keep possession.
You can't give away these types of opportunities in the red zone. And I'm sure that was flashing through his brain as the ball escaped his hands. Fortunately for him, able to get picked up by his team, fumble recover, they still have an opportunity deep in the red zone.
On third down, Brennan. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Here we go with McCaffrey. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. On the ground,
McCaffrey. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
At the Bears' 8-yard line.
Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought,
yeah,
is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. Operating from the gun, Brennan. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
Well, they've had success getting the ball to him out of the backfield, but this time they had a man right on him. He was able to break that play up before he could get started.
Play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on 4th and goal. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And no, it's incomplete. They had the play call on 4th and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And the Bears will get the football back.
Turnover on downs.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears' offense. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because they're still a long way away from kneel down time. So they've got to work on getting first downs, keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going. And above all, ball security. Don't turn it over.
Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on 2nd down or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. And this will be a gain of right around 3 from the 7 out to the 10-yard line. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. Now this is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Back to throw here. And the throw there going to be incomplete. And that went off the mark a little late with the throw.
It's now 4th down.
Here comes the Bears punter now. And you wonder, could they possibly think about taking a safety here? It's a 39-yard punt, and good coverage means a loss on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the #1 headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. So 2nd down, still 10 yards to go, ball on the 43. This is McCaffrey on the give. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. An incompletion, now a short pickup. That's not going
to
do it.
Yeah, you got to get to the line of scrimmage quickly, get set up, and aim downfield.
They'll look to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down. They needed four. He doubled that. He wound up getting eight.
And a Panther first down.
Now here's a whistle as flags come in. And we'll check out the call. The crowd's not doing that O-line any favors.
Home field advantage is really kicking in, making it very difficult for them to hear the snap count.
The false start backs him up five, first and 15. Off play action, Brennan. Open man is Samuel, complete. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. That's good for 28 yards. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. For the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Intended for DJ Moore. Harrison Smith on the coverage.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Quick throw complete into the flat out left. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
He steps out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Sack, and now maybe just time for one final play. And down by five, they've got to go for it here on fourth down. He'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off down near the five. And that is going to seal this victory as time runs out.
Today's final score, Bears 21.
Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here. Coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, three, four, five plays are